kind of dangerous. Feels like it's a loaded gun. My mind is turning like a cloud of dust. My heart always wants to run. Oh, if you want.
You were trying to talk over the radio, you didn't come through?
Radio check.
Get him, Charlie.
Yeah, this is Charlie 604. I'm back 10-8. Individual was walking by my car with a rifle in his hand while I was on break. I've got one individual down on his knees, cuffing now. Charlie 604, code 4, be back. That'll be 10:15 with one male. Back to station. That's one heck of a way to start the stream. Let's see. Oh man, person. No active warrants or anything, but brandishing a firearm. Weapons license. license. I'll just take him back to station and let that be. That was kind of crazy anyway. Charlie 604, showing back 10-8. That was a crazy way to start the stream. Sitting on break and guys, welcome back with an automatic rifle. Just like, la-dee-dee, da-da-da. Oh man, let's see, Mason should be getting on here shortly. Be running, running duos. Get our car ramrod on. That was crazy. Traffic does seem to be a lot lighter at nighttime. And the guy didn't slow down at all. He's falling for a little bit. Anything stupid. Sense of stopping all the way with the cop right under us. Lady, See your driver's license, proof of insurance. Ike Sue. That's one heck of a name for a lady. Passenger's name. Okay. Alright, do me a favor and sit tight. Charlie 604, I'll be on a 1011, Route 68, Panorama Drive, intersection, Postal 279. Valid. Let's check that plate. 85 NTN 42. Homeowner's Apperson. I pulled you over.
Well, yeah.
Yes, I know you live down the block, but that doesn't really answer my question now, does it? Where are you heading to? Rockford Hill Sex Club, huh? Oh, yes. All right. You had anything to drink today? Maybe, but you don't want to talk about it? Okay. Seriously, when was your last drink? You want anything else? Any drugs in the vehicle? Did you use any drugs today? Okay, the reason why I stopped you is because you were driving a little erratically. You weren't stopping at stop signs. And I was concerned that you might be under the influence of something. So I'm going to try to do a breathalyzer right through the window. You don't even have to get out. 0%. Good deal. We'll do a little swabby swab just to make sure you're not on anything else. Outstanding. All right. Just make sure you drive a little bit safer out there. Don't get in too much trouble tonight at the sex club. All right, you're free to go. Charlie 604, show me back 10-8.
Starting your route. Continue straight.
Charlie 604, heading into city for event training.
Thank you.
those feet. Excuse me. Pardon me.
In 1/10 of a mile, keep left, continue straight. Take the exit. Continue straight. Keep left. You have arrived.
Fellas,
it's raining outside.
Oh, we got some more people coming.
All right.
You guys done trainings in LSPD for stuff like this?
I don't know. I don't know.
LSPD? Whoever does that?
You.
I would never, yeah. I don't know. What are you accusing me of?
Have any of you other departments had trainings for stuff like this or not?
Different worlds, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, BCSO is very different from LSPD. Just a tier above.
But Polito Bay, on the other hand,
I don't know about that one.
I don't know. Polito Bay seems to be on top.
Since when are officers allowed to run a leg strap holster?
Per our department, we're allowed to.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Polito Bay on top.
No. Mm-hmm.
That is stupid.
I agree.
According
I agree
to you. Oh, you guys are jealous. Just jealous.
Objectively
yeah.
dumb.
Just a little jealous. Bit.
I mean, I don't care. I have one.
Yeah, I know. Newton has one. He gets it.
But LSPD, you don't get to run it until you're a fucking lieutenant.
Just like Polito Bay on
that
top.
Sucks.
Uh-huh.
Alright, so I guess we'll get started with a little bit of briefings. Let's see if anybody else shows up, but we got about 9 people here. I think that's all that was interested, so let's see. So basically, The sting training we're doing is going to be setting perimeters, setting effective perimeters, knowing where to set your perimeters and how to set your perimeters, while still allowing, like if it's on a main street, a large building like the one we're going to be doing, you'll want to still allow traffic through so they don't get caught in any kind of crossfire. So we'll show you how to set that up. You'll also want to, when you have a destination in mind, say the call that we're portraying today is a civilian was stopped on a traffic stop, shot the officer, kidnapped the officer, and has fled and barricaded himself inside of the Mile High Club. We're unsure as to what room he's in or what part of the building he's in, so we're going to lock down the whole perimeter and we're going to clear the building from bottom to top. Where are you going? Come back. Preferably in these kinds of situations, you would want to clear it top to bottom while holding perimeter on the outside, at least a block. But top to bottom is more of a SWAT function since we have the SWAT in the city. So we'll focus more on officer actions instead of SWAT actions. And that's going to be like setting the perimeters, establishing what the entry points and exit points are, possible routes of evasion. You want to block those off. And then we'll go about sweeping the building. But basically, since we're going to be doing the Mile High Club, everybody knows Mile High Club's going to be 744, right across from Spawn. Pretty large block. Normally, if we had enough people, we would set in each main intersection at least one or two officer cars. That way they could keep eyes on the road, see if anybody's running through there. They'll hold the innermost lanes. When you're setting intersections, you'll hold the innermost lane to allow the traffic to go outside. That way you're not shooting fast traffic. And then once that's established, during certain circumstances, it would be definitely up to your department how you handle these situations. But certain circumstances, the perimeter units would show up not running code. They'd be nice and quiet, lights off, sirens off. They'd set up their perimeters and then they'd turn their lights on, no sirens, and allow the traffic through and just quietly hold that perimeter. And then once the other units get there, because you don't want to alert your suspect that they're being barricaded until your other units who are ready to storm the building are there, let them know, hey, we're here, we're gonna barricade the building, let yourself be known.
Well, let's try that again.
Mm-hmm.
that's good. Charlie 604, I'm back 10-8 after code 0.
And 4.
Alright, guess I'll go put some gas in her. Back home.
Charlie 309, I'm going to be responding to a 911 call of a homeless disturbance. It's going to be a 319.
Charlie 604 is going to be 10-6 for fuel. Charlie 604 is back 10-8. Bring it on, lady.
Charlie 309, Charlie 604 direct.
Go for 604.
I can get you over here at 318. Got a bunch of homeless people.
Starting your route.
10-4, heading your way.
Continue straight.
Shit! Go back to your home.
In 1/10 of a mile, turn right. Turn right. Continue straight.
Charlie 604 is on scene. What the heck is going on over here, man?
I pulled up and there's homeless people everywhere.
Does he have a torch in his hand?
It's a flare. It's like a road flare.
So, what were they doing there? Were they just standing there like they are right now?
Yeah, I mean, they're trespassing, that's for sure.
So we just need to run them off, you think? Or should we, like,
yeah,
search them? Or see if they're on anything?
You want to search them, maybe just get them out of here.
It's like I see one with their hands up. Did you do that, or somebody holding her hostage?
I did not do that.
I don't see any visible weapons. Alright, young fella, we'll start with you.
Hey, buddy. You want to drop the square the road cord for me?
Well, hey, this one over here is drunk as a skunk. Be out in public, all snookered up. See what else he's got on him. He ain't got nothing on him. Yeah, I searched him. He ain't got nothing on him, but he's drunk as a skunk.
This dude's got stolen keys to a BCSO vehicle.
Well, that'll look. see that fella running back here? See that one fellow back here running his ass off. I don't know where he's
yeah,
going.
I got a red dot on him.
Oh, okay.
I think he's the ringleader. He took off running as soon as I pulled up. but he's not running very far, so I'm not too concerned about it.
Kind of slow. I'll search her, just make sure she's good. Yeah, she's good to go. All right, get out of here. I guess she just seen hands up, like seen us roll up here and put her hands up. So I guess I'm gonna get good old boy for loitering and being drunk in public.
He's got his flare back out.
Will you knock that out of his hand? Oh, yeah, let go. He's a dancing. He's a dancing.
Yeah.
Wow, whatever. he just like didn't, that didn't faze him at all. You sure he's not on like some LSD or something? Wonder if I tackle him if it'll knock it loose. Where'd you go?
My dog was being gay.
Oh. Yeah, I said he was acting nervous and stuff. Jerry, search him.
You get my Discord call?
I see it now. Here we go. Yeah, where I'm on streamer mode, it doesn't.
Oh.
I don't hear it. That's why I didn't hear it yesterday either.
I mean, I could just confiscate these keys and send him on his way.
It's up to you.
Go after old buddy that's running over there.
Yeah, he's probably got more on him. Hey, he's still running over there. Look at him.
You got a crackhead in the back of your car?
I do. He's a drunk, but.
Oh.
He had, I'm going to get him for loitering and being over the limit in public, drunk in public.
All right, I'm going to go after this guy up here.
Well, he's a running. He's going to get hit.
Where are you going, buddy? Oh, you just died? He just died on me.
Me? Oh.
He just.
He's doing the T pose. Oh. Yeah, he is glitched out on you.
Oh, he's bleeding out now.
On my screen, he's doing the T pose. Oh, hang on. Hey, you want this fella?
It's okay. I mean, if you don't want to do it, I'll do it.
Oh, it don't matter to me. Only reason I do paperwork so that maybe they'll let me take his stupid hat off. We called for code 4.
Charlie 309, code 4, going to be 10-8.
Oh, you canceled it. Gotcha. Charlie 604 is back 10-8 also.
Hmm.
the highways got all kinds of automatic invalid registration, parking violations. It's all over the highway. I did get a stolen vehicle earlier. He
really?
Didn't run on me.
Really?
Yeah. He pulled over and...
Did you code 5 him?
Nah, there wasn't nobody on but me.
Oh.
I think Smith got on, and then he was doing a 1080 while I was on a traffic. And I was already on the call before he got to the 1080. And he went to the city, and the city called him off because they're doing training.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, he got pissed. And then the guy was like, you don't have one guy that can drop off for the... And the guy got on the skybox. It was like, I told you to eliminate the call. I mean, they're getting kind of shitty towards each other. And then I haven't seen him. I think he got off because there's another fella in town. I went to that training and then code zeroed, and I'm like, I'm not going all the way back down there.
Yeah, I'm good.
I'm not at that level yet. I'm still trying to learn how to make a freaking... how to call out on the radio, right?
But...
Ew.
We went and talked to our property manager today. I got off work early, and was talking about everything that's been going on, and I seen that they had a one of those townhomes that I was pointing at. They've got one for about $200 more than what we're paying right now, and I told them if they'll let us, you know, not do the buyout and everything, we'll take it and we'll move over there. And she's working on getting us out of our buyout so we can transfer to one of those units.
What do you mean by buyout? You like your deposit and all that shit, so you don't have to redo all that?
No. So, where we signed a 13-month lease, if we decide we want to leave early, we have to buy out of our contract.
Oh shit!
For not counting us.
Good luck with that. You know how many leases I broke?
They're really tight on it now. I mean, even at work.
Yeah, they gotta take you to court though to do anything about it. In a small claims court, good luck.
Yeah.
I ain't never. Dealt with it. Anyway, go ahead.
Well, they're working on getting us out of that buyout so we can transfer over to one of those townhomes. And they're just like this apartment. They're just bigger and nicer and like an actual house. We don't have nobody below us or on top of us.
It's got the little garages, don't it?
Yeah, we'll have a garage too. It's like a little duplex. So I might be moving again.
At least you ain't got too much crap to move.
No. As I said, the couch, we could literally walk it down the street.
What was that postal?
Right down the
I never remember that. Called me to it. It's like 816 or something.
318. East Joshua Road.
Seven Whitehall. Rude. Up in Grape Seed. He ain't got no home address. That's where his mama lives.
Mm-hmm.
state, let's see. Public intoxication is like drunk tank, but it should be on here, right?
I think I had to fill it in once.
Public intoxication. Bam! There it is. And then loitering is probably not, because that's probably a misdemeanor. You don't normally
arrest. Trespassing.
Yeah, that might be on there, yeah. Let's do misdemeanor trespassing. I got him for a public intoxication. Drinking in public. Good enough. All right, let's see if I can take this fool in. Come with me, handsome. We're gonna get your picture taken. Stop resisting! You out on the patrol?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Where's it at? Right here, yeah. Smile for the camera. Alright, come on. Alright, I'm gonna see if there's an actual spot you can drop them off in here. That would be nice. I don't know, on LSPDFR you kinda had that option to do either. That way. Pick a cell, any cell. This one's got a shiny schnitter on it.
Mm-hmm. Freshly cleaned.
Yeah. I think he cleaned it with his tongue. Sir, I'm going to send you to see Big Bob. Tell him I said hello. Let's see. 6/50. You have a nice time in prison. Bye bye. He gone. Run in. You want to ride together?
If you want me to, I'll head that way.
Yeah, let's do that. That way we can catch what each other's doing on stream here. FDV. I'm about to delete all these damn cars. Get out of here. This is my station. That's you. Honking your horn like it.
Huh?
Is that you with your siren on like it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thanks, sir. Don't hit me! Oh, he's got the truck out. Looky here. You are banned from this server. Ban time remaining 30 days. Oh, wow.
Jesus.
They must have stole NPC card, no Civ RP. Your ban ID is this. Well, I mean, that's what people do when they first come in, right? Try to get a car to go somewhere.
I don't know if he knew.
Maybe not.
Poor guy.
Poor feller. All right, well. Charlie 309 and Charlie 604 will be running his Union 1. Not that anybody's listening right now. I'm glad Wade's out of them, to be honest with you.
Clear the air.
What was that?
I can say whatever I want through RTO because no one's in this channel.
Yeah, they're all in that training. That I only seen one other guy down there that was BCSO. I got gas like 3 times since I've been on, had no issues. What are you lighting him up for? Oh, never mind.
He's just stopped in the middle of the road.
Hi, Mama. My mom said we're hilarious. Mason's doing a really good job of watching his mouth. Because he's on Facebook.
Are you streaming on Facebook too now?
I'm now streaming on Twitch, Facebook, and YouTube all at the same time. Might as well spread the love. She said hi, baby, and I'm almost 98% sure she's talking to me. You gonna light him up? What's happening?
Oh, yeah.
What do you do? Oh, you gotta.
He was stopped in the middle of the road. Oh!
He's got a. Got a flag for registration or something, don't he?
He doesn't want to pull over.
Is he not letting you use the X thing? Make him mimic you or whatever?
No, I think he's bugged.
Oh Lord. Oh Lord.
What is this?
That's a ghost car right there. You got it?
Yeah. You can see him throw his hands up at me? Wow, really?
Oh, well, that'll teach him.
That is not where you should stop whatsoever.
Yeah, I would make him mimic you all the way up to the dirt. Right, now, they do go crazy sometimes. Where'd you call it off? Oh, ooh.
No,
I couldn't get the little blue marker to go up that far.
Charlie 309 going to be on a 1011 on a white smart car. Going to be 334 Sonora Freeway, X51 one times no 32.
Car Ramrod. Car Ramrod.
What?
Call us this Car Ramrod. 02. 772.
Hey, buddy. Dylan Fick.
Yeah, that's the owner of the vehicle. Let's see. Ooh, that's nasty. He ain't got nothing. He's all good. I would just make him feel like an idiot for driving like an idiot.
Yeah, he's being really nice to me. He's talking all polite and everything. I'm just letting him go.
Well.
He said, how can I help you this morning?
All right, kiss ass, you can go.
Why are we stopped up here?
Somebody out of their vehicle.
Union 1, we're going to be out with 1-334. It's going to be on Grant's Nor Highway.
Get out and get her.
What's she doing?
I don't know. Let me see if I can get her to the side of the road. Or you got it.
You go ahead.
Okay.
I'll deal with some of these cars.
Let me see if I can get her real quick. All right, we're out.
Hey, out of towner, why don't you move it, okay?
I'm starting to leap towards. Is that her car, you think? Shit, is that one empty?
There was like three empty ones.
All right, lady, what do you want? Just be standing out in the middle of the road like that. Huh? I'm gonna have you blown to this tube right here.
Search for Brazier.
I'll let you do that part. Well, you ain't been drinking. I'm going to swab your cheek right there on the inside. We're going to see how much meth you've been doing today. Nothing. Wow.
She drunk?
No, nothing. She's not drunk. She ain't on nothing. She's just old and senile, I guess.
Shane yep. Goins. Oh.
You want to run her? Or... since she's out in the middle of the street. I won't. Oh,
you want to not stand in the middle of the road for us?
Whoa, yikes. Ooh.
Okay.
How'd you run her standing there?
Dispatch? Menu? G?
No shit.
Yeah.
Well. You didn't need me to run her name all those times.
Well, I just let you do it, you know. Thank you. Gives you something to do rather than just sit there.
That's true, I guess. Hell, you don't even need that CAD system.
It's literally
it's good
just
for the address.
Yeah.
That's about it. Alright, Hooker. If I tell you to walk on somewhere. Oh, shut up. If I tell you to go on somewhere, you're not going to walk out in the middle of traffic, are you? Alright. Go back to the mental hospital. Be careful. Don't you bump into me.
Go back to the home. The kids put you there for a reason.
Hey, watch her scratch her head. I think she's like literally like lost. Look at her head down and everything. It looks kind of sad.
She wasn't high?
No. Nothing.
Maybe let's give her a ride.
Where are you going to drop her off?
I don't know yet. We'll figure that out. Miss. Hey.
The matter can't. Well, drive.
Come here.
She is Asian as hell. Do you hear an accent?
Excuse me.
She sounded a little bit racist towards white people. I'm just going to throw that out there.
I'm just putting you in cuffs to help you.
Our safety and yours. Where are you going to take her to?
Charlie, or Union 1, we're going to be 10-6 for public transport.
Jeez.
I see your registration's expired. Jerk.
Scooby-Doo.
typical glitcheroni. Please don't crash. I ain't crashed all day. Well, one time. Just want to take her ass to prison, huh?
And gives her somewhere for her family to pick her up.
It works.
I'll find out. Oh, it's not popping up the menu. Jesus.
Oh, let me get out.
Well,
she's not in there. Oh.
Yeah, I just sent her to the oblivion.
Have fun, lady!
If we just leave her here, so she walks around, we're gonna find her on the highway, like, plastered.
The last guy we let walk off ended up beating the crap out of a sheriff with his fishing pole. We let him off with a warning or just a fishing license. He came a ticket. Next fucking county guy he seen, he just started whooping him. That's hilarious. Come on. Invalid registration.
On what?
On that Pinto that about ran into you.
Oh. I'm tired of dealing with Pintos. That's all that's out here.
Hey, I did go across the bridge over into that side of the county. On the other side of the freeway. Mm-hmm. And I got a guy tried running from me on foot.
I mean, we can go up there. There's a little trailer park community we can visit.
Yeah, it's a little bit different than the normal stamping grounds. Vespucci Boulevard, Chasin. They're training.
Ain't my job.
Yeah, they're up there training. That's what that is. Is it bad I still gotta, like, I'm kind of scared to go off-road because of the last city we were in?
Yeah, I get the same way.
Like, yeah, is this a road? Oh, what don't matter in here? Nobody even walking around up here sitting on my porch or nothing.
This is like Staff City.
Usually Staff City you see people at the stage and stuff, but there wasn't there last time we went, was it?
Nope.
Huh. They must have that turned down. I know
probably
the traffic's
bad on its own.
Really? I know the traffic's insane. Yeah, I was up here across from his chemical plant, old dude. Pulled him over for something on the license plate reader. When I got him out of the car, he took off. Oh, breathe it in. All that chemical smoke, gas. Look how slow everybody's driving. What the hell is going on? too. Everybody's driving it slow. Yeah, you picking up speed.
That one, the truck was doing 42.
It's in the 50 though.
Yeah.
I think they speed up on more up the road there. See how they're starting to speed up once they get up there? Let's try that. On the highway, don't it?
Yeah.
What's down there? See that?
Yeah, there's Scott.
There's another fool out in the middle of the road. Oh, on my screen it says it's a traffic accident. I see it now.
Red SUV in Paul?
I don't know, they're cutting in their car.
Anyone, we're going to be out with one for an NBA at 548 Sonora Freeway on ramp to Olympic.
You're blocking my way and
hold on, Pappy. I'm going to mute myself for a minute.
Union 1's back code for show us 10-6 for about two mics. Well, you never Mace, pull us up a little bit so his truck can get by. It's going to start screwing up traffic. Oh, I just needed. There's one way of doing it. dude. Yeah. Keep it moving. Nobody's here now. It'll get my stick out. Nobody's here. Keep on going. Nothing to see here. Horn blows. Blow it out your dog. God, go on. Well, you see my stick. Keep it moving. Next person blows their horn at me, yes sir, God. Shut up. Here in my stick. Hello. Well. Keep it moving.
I'm back.
Yay!
Tristan FaceTimed me.
Oh, Tristan did?
Yeah. What was that all about?
They kept trying to come up this road, and you kind of had it blocked, and they didn't want to go, and... Yeah. Anyway. You knew when we were back, 10-8. And we're going the wrong way. Nothing to see here.
This freaking truck has a turning radius of a Mac.
Mm-hmm.
I really gotta
give it. Excuse us, pardon me. Keep it moving.
Someone doing 72 up here. Who's this riding me?
I don't know. Let him go by and see how fast he goes.
Oh, 80.
I mean, it's highway. I'm not really supposed to do anything on the highway.
You better shut up. Throw a battery at you.
Damn.
you slowing down for, man?
Alright. You know, I haven't gotten any call-outs.
I haven't either.
Wonder if they shut them off for the, event.
Their headlights are bright. It's a fog. This is where me and Zach caught Breaking Bad doing 70 down 68. Or Joshua. I just got a call out.
Oh, that's good.
Hit and run. Yeah, four.
I think another reason why they sound so bad to me is because I hear them through your speakers too.
Suspicion person reported right here in front of us.
Oh,
he's running. Oh. Union 1, we got a active 1070. He's going to be running off foot. 230.
North down. Oh. I just crashed.
I did too.
Oh. Nice. Dang.
I had to have gotten everybody. That was a hard crash too. It was like straight to the desktop.
Didn't like it's no still time. Running the error for me. Now I can close it. Damn. 5M was struggling earlier. They sent out a thing on the announcements.
So. Yeah. I seen that. Yup. Oh, it's on. Oh. What's next? What's next? What's next?
Immortal she returned
to... It's so loud.
Me off.
I tried turning it down on my stream so it didn't blast it.
Charlie 309, we code 0, disregard our last. I felt like I heard that guy start to say something like right when I crashed. I don't know if you got that too.
Yeah. Pull my car out and put this rifle up because it won't let me do it in yours. It says there's one already in there when I do it.
Charlie 309, Charlie 604 going to be running as Union 1. We're also going to be 10-8. Take the little charger.
Suspects van north to Lethal Way. Is that a bug zapper? Dude.
Yeah. Charlie 309, mic check.
Hey, Charlie.
Cool.
I was just seeing if there was still someone.
Hey, do you see that store down there?
Which store?
It's to our left.
Yeah. That's a slicker.
Got a red circle around it. I don't think you saw that last time, did you?
No, it's random for everyone.
Okay.
We'll head right over there just a second. Look at that.
Oh, did you find it was like page up or page down? I think it was.
Charlie 311, Signal 11, Eastbound Panorama Drive, 27 cell phone.
Signal 11? That's not
10-11.
A thing.
Well, did he say Signal?
Yeah, he said Signal 11. That's
I,
not
I
a...
can't say nothing, nobody.
Oh, yeah, it is. That's running radar.
Gunshots, you hear that?
Oh, did you hear gunshots?
It's probably that red circle, man.
Yep. Anyone, we got gunshots in the area of 287, kind of towards 272.
The liquor store.
We're going to be investigating the area.
Ooh,
I hear it.
311, 1080, westbound Joshua Road, 276 on a two-door vehicle. I'm also getting gunshots coming from that vehicle as well.
Oh, that's okay. Him then.
Four Union ones with you. Oh, it's Smith.
Oh yeah, he's glitching all over the place.
I'm gonna back off a little bit, take the distance.
They showed me the spike strip. Keybind, but I can't remember what it is. I'm gonna keep a good distance from him.
He's not gonna stop. We gotta do something.
Okay.
going in the city.
I'll go ahead and just 10-5 through the ball. He's gonna be stopped now.
Ooh, I'm hit. I'm hit.
Oh. I got him. I hit him. I got a headshot on him.
Probably 311, if you want to go ahead and start approaching, I'll approach from this direction.
So I got my ammo down here for this guy.
Well, I got the red X. I popped his ass.
I just love getting shot at.
I love the county. And
right between the eyes.
What's the spike strip menu? Do you know?
It's gonna be keybind and your 5M keybinds. I forget what it's under there.
Yeah, I always forget.
Do we have to do some type of report for discharging them?
Yeah, a micro SMG had an Uzi.
Yes, we would if there's a supervisor on, but there's no supervisor, so we can't.
The 11 Quincy County Corner, County Tow, Northbound Sonora Road, 369.
Damn!
Dick. Oh, I'm not good doing this no more. You got me good. Appreciate it.
All right, brother.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yep.
It's right control. Union 1 going to be 10-8.
3-11, requesting mechanic for the South Thompson Road, 369, for the same plane count, Sheriff's Office, 14 Charger.
I didn't shoot my gun. Did you shoot your gun?
Yeah, I dropped it. I got the red X. Right between the eyes.
We didn't shoot our guns.
I did! I shot him, boss. I shot him.
Why is my vehicle refusing to go over 39 miles per hour?
What's your engine show?
It's perfectly fine. Here, let me try. There we go.
Honestly, I don't mind the Crown Vic. I really hate the way y'all look. If they would just let me. That's the only thing I hate the way I look. I wouldn't even mind keep driving that Crown Vic.
You're allowed to. Like, once you get promoted, you can still drive it.
I'm old school anyway. I don't mind no Crown Vic. trust a fart. Don't ever trust a fart. Might not go just as planned.
Especially the older you get, I imagine.
Yeah.
I soured myself on the way to work the other day.
So the more medications you're on, you just can't.
Jeez, he's flying.
Who was?
That truck.
Damn, look
trailer.
At that trailer! That trailer's all over the place.
Yeah. No way. He's taking off. Ooh, domestic disturbance. I really want to take it.
Let's do it. Cancel that.
It's not loading. We'll take the 1080.
Okay.
My bad. Sorry. Union 1, we got an active 1080. We're going to be heading westbound Zancudo River, Route 68, passing 379 now. Going to be on a gray truck. Speed's about 70. Passing mile marker 20.02. Gonna be at 403, continuing westbound towards Zancudo. I'm new here.
Are you at on 68, basically?
Yeah, affirmative. Be passing 409 now. Four 16.
Break his ass off the side and say 1050.
Ooh.
Get to his left. Get up here in front of him to the left so we don't go left. Fuck, dude.
He said he was gonna go left anyway. We kinda got him stopped here at 419. We're not out yet.
He's out running.
He's on foot. 419, 1070.
Shit. I've been dying to tackle somebody. Oh, he's fast. I'm coming.
Can you slow him down?
That is messed up.
Hands.
No way.
Oh, is he trying to run?
Yeah, he's trying to run while I was cuffing him. Oh, he's still running. That's hilarious.
Taser deployed.
Ah!
Oh!
Oh!
Grab his info and use code 0.
He don't care. He does not care about those cuffs.
He's code 0.
Damn it.
Dude, just get his info and count him. We can still do the report and all that.
We'll do. That's one
like
that. Whoops.
Yeah, they got 5 weapons discharge for him.
Go do CPR to death.
Got it.
Did you get his info?
Yeah. Union 1, we're going to be code 4 here. We're going to go back tonight.
I probably shouldn't have blown his brains out right there in front of another cop, but, you know.
Maybe code 0'd. I don't see why it matters. But. We want to do paperwork on that, or where it's a code 0, just say fuck it?
Yeah. I will not.
Damn it. And we missed out on a domestic dispute.
Well, those won't load for me. Like, every time I've tried to take one, it just sits there and spins. He was doing 54 and a 40. Catch them coming around this corner. He's done 43. Seven, 48.
50.
That's the money shot. Oh, he's flying. 54. And he's riding him.
Oh, yeah. Going towards county. That's what I like.
It's you, pal. You will be taking the ride today. Oh, my God. He's bugged. Dang it. He meant to say TikToks. He's watching TikToks.
He's not a corporal or nothing, is he?
Nah, he's same as me. 50. 50, not 60.
60. It's that same fucking truck. He's hauling ass. 61.
Damn!
Oh!
is this? Oh my god. That is just bug nation right Alrighty. There.
Oh, just spawn out of nowhere. Did you see it?
Yeah.
Damn!
We're gonna get one here.
56? You get up to 52.
This is a little hot spot.
Come down to see
how far. EM1, we're going to be signal 11 on 409 Tonga Hills.
Fucking pickup trucks, dude. It's that same fucking type of truck.
He's doing 50.
Yep.
I seen 54.
Yeah, me too.
55? He's gonna run that sign. He's gonna run it. He ran the hell out of it. They not doing what they're supposed to be doing? Yeah, he's just, I don't know. That's strange. Try again. Ooh, that seems 59. Look at this little station wagon and his back window smashed out.
It's like they're used to running,
on 311, channel 11, eastbound route 68, 409, on a, journey van, white and colored, I'm back on 132.
They're not like, it's not actually pulling them over though. Like, it's like we won't be able to interact with them or anything.
Huh.
I don't know what the hell this is.
Just try pulling over anybody right now and see what it is.
That was a bad attempt. He started doing it though. He started doing what it normally does.
Hmm.
That's okay. This guy's doing 53.
Yeah, I'd stop right here. Let it be it. Is it when you try to move him?
No, it's just it. That's working perfectly fine. It's just some traffic stops are not, like, actually doing the stop.
21 SDG.
Union 1 going to be on a 1011 406 on a gray hatchback, occupied 2 times, no 32.
I know I spelled that wrong. L-A-R-E-A.
Any warrants?
Fugitive warrant. Driver's license expired. Hunting license expired. Weapons expired. Fugitive warrant. Son of a bitch. He's on a call, isn't he?
I think there's someone else now.
Okay.
Trying to think what would be the best postal to give for this.
Union 1 requesting 32s to 409 Tongva Hills. Bueno Vino Road for a code 5 stop.
Be wired down once this meet us at North Station.
What did he say?
10-9.
We gotta go to the North Station with Toledo Bay and Sandra Tower Control.
So that means he's not coming?
East station.
Oh, we all gotta go there.
Oh, so we gotta cancel this? Son of a bitch! Just gonna teleport?
Yeah. North Station.
State. SASP North Station?
I'd assume so.
I don't see any other names popping up. $300.
Where's that at?
Yeah, Wade's gone too.
There is no... Oh, yeah, there is.
Which one is it?
It's Sandy Sheriff.
That's our place.
Yeah.
There's Wade's fucking dog again.
There's no one here. Where are we supposed to be going?
Destination 546.
Gotcha.
Is that where we were?
No, he said 546 now.
Well,
I'm crashing. What's next?
It's East Highway.
The East Highway.
Mm-hmm.
Are you there?
Mm-hmm. So is everybody else.
You know, I don't know if that's a good idea.
Just wait for the meeting to start. I'm sure we'll find out sooner or later.
All I know is my sheriff told me to come down here, and I came down here.
I can't. I'm quite shit myself. Hope I'm not in trouble.
Yeah, guys, just line up. You're ready to use. Ben, go ahead and stand down there with the rest of everybody.
Welcome. Valley 01, I'm sure I'll be to you, so go ahead and shoot down to 546 East Highway Station.
Welcome, kid.
Thank you,
thank you.
A604, they're not taking your ass off.
Take your hats off.
Oh.
No.
They get here with you. I think it's just you, bro.
I just can't understand you. I don't know.
Get if how you I'd put that pack on.
Oh, God. Yeah, cover that thing.
Holy.
That's even worse.
Bald.
Oh, shiny.
Guys, go ahead and sweat your vests, alright?
Bald is
beautiful. Maybe I do just need
thank you.
Oh, that's real official.
That hairline is whack.
What hairline?
The one that's receding to, like, gravity.
How's everybody doing? Everybody having a good night?
Yeah, doing alright.
Nah.
So far.
I'm okay. Good. I'm fine.
I'm alive.
Oh wait, I gotta.
There you go.
My girlfriend's not being a nice lady at the moment, so.
What the f?
Miller, hat off, vest off.
Don't worry about that, buddy.
How's your day going, Commander?
Well, Monday's in the books, so that's always good.
Yeah, working on Monday sucks.
Wait, Monday? It's Tuesday.
I don't know. Once you get to my age,
wait, is it Tuesday?
No matter what day it
I
is,
thought it was Monday.
Be fucked up.
I don't know. I don't even know what fucking day it is.
Thursdays, Wednesdays, Tuesdays, Mondays, fuck them all.
Yes.
Indeed. Fuck them all.
Yeah.
Wonder what this is about.
Especially Sunday.
I'm gonna go stand back here for the rest of BCS, you know.
Oh yeah.
You stand wherever you like, my friend. Just make sure you can hear. Oh shit, that's me. Hey Anthony.
What's up?
God damn it. Nudie. Commander.
Motherfucker, can you stop calling me? Little bastard.
State police. Got another Ed Fair on there, so don't go to state.
Valentine.
Yeah. I have the logs that show otherwise.
He was asking about my grandma because she's been put in hospital.
Oh, really?
He's actually right. Easier well, to understand.
Happily.
How's she doing?
Lost a leg.
Okay.
He said, okay.
Her nickname's Peggy.
He said, okay.
I mean, that's a shame. I'm sorry to hear
right,
that.
Right, don't laugh.
Yes.
Don't be dancing in here.
Damn poor Roger.
You danced about my
why
nan
is
losing
this
her leg.
That's enough stuff, bro.
Commander, could we get a little insight as to what this meeting's about?
Just be patient, bro. All
right.
Be respectful, guys.
I try.
I love the Poindexter haircut he's got.
I swear to God.
How would you understand the meeting, sir?
Yeah. Or it's stationary. Solid copy.
The only reason it's stationary is
because
there's a bunch of BCS over in here.
I think really just any of this stuff smells like it stinks to you. So.
Nah, like lavender.
Now, if we could get a photo op and have everyone line up against the wall, that would be really nice.
Am I allowed my sunglasses on in here or not?
Say again?
Should I take my sunglasses off just for respectfulness?
I don't think I'm crashing.
Nope. Not prescription, I'd say, yeah.
Just for looks, man. I try to dress appropriately.
Alright. Alrighty, boys.
We just had a meeting.
Let's wait. Everybody, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Coolio. So we want to address this jurisdictional issue. We're not going to dive too much in on the jurisdiction stuff as you guys have a map of it within your SOP. But I keep noticing, some of the state guys going on Joshua, cutting through Sandy. I don't know what that's about. The only route that you guys have that cuts across the state and that goes through the county is 68, and that is your guys' jurisdiction. So obviously, you guys see that it's in your SOP, with the whole map layout. It's the pink line. That's drawn right through the county. You guys are able to patrol that area. Now, when it comes to panics, we get it. You guys what, have like a mile radius to respond to if it's outside of your jurisdiction. The way that we did it in the other place or the other city is that if you're within this certain radius, then you're able to respond to that panic. That's fine. No, you're not going to be getting docked any sort of points or anything along the lines of that. It's just when you show up to the panic, ask them if, you know, that whether it's BCSO, LSPD, if they got enough guys to help out, or
this is
if,
gay.
You know, they would like a hand. And then, you know, if they ask you, hold on, give me 1 second.
Can't you just fucking get the guy that did it and fucking pull him to the side?
So just ask them, see if they need an extra hand. If not, you know, they can tell you that you're good to go back to your area, and we'll move along that way.
Yes.
Same thing with the call-outs. Make sure that you're, you know, if you need to go to a different jurisdiction, reach out to the sergeant, supervisor, whoever it is that you need to get in contact to. Let them know. Ask them if it's okay. Then they'll let you know.
I've got a question.
Go ahead.
So, basically, so I understand what you mean, but if anyone needs to, like, go for, like, refuel or something, we shouldn't really be needing to ask if we can go into else's
jurisdiction. Because it's...
Yeah. Because I got told off for going for a refuel. And then also respond to a panic. because I was in the area at the time after I refueled, and I got told off for that.
Okay, so refueling, you guys do have gas stations within your jurisdiction. You got one off of Sonora, you got one right there by Polito, you got one right off the 68, so just use those ones. And then, yeah, if there's a panic that goes off in that area, and then, you know, you have to be by the proper refuel station, then get told off, then let a supervisor know, then they'll reach out to the chain of command, we'll get it resolved. That's another thing too. Nobody should be necessarily.
So kind of piggyback on that there, it's, you know, if you're responding to a panic, make sure you're going into the, you know, respective department's channel and let them know you're responding to that panic. I understand that the dynamic some situations can present where that can get confused, you know what I mean? If you're heading somewhere for a panic, it's 22 and then you happen to be refueling, obviously there can be some confusion, you know. State your purpose, you know, clearly, and get out of there, whatever. The biggest thing here is it's communication, right? So if we're going somewhere for a panic, if we're going somewhere to refuel, if you have to go refuel, someone else's jurisdiction is what it is.
Oh, shit, sorry.
Make sure you're calling it out. Obviously, you know, it's ideal for us to stay on the highways and refuel, right? It's ideal for us to stay on the highway for callouts, everything else.
It's like Rihanna.
I don't want to discourage anyone from responding to panics that are within their, you know, their radius and everything else. But at the same time, we just have to make sure that we're executing those correctly, right? Getting in those channels, letting people know if we're responding, you know, and if they don't need us, we're gonna, you know, go back tonight. All right.
Got a homicide call out. Damn it!
Your car's sputtering. Sparks out of its exhaust pipe for whatever reason. I don't know why that does that. It doesn't really make any sense. But other than that, if you need to refuel that desperately outside of your jurisdiction from coming back from a panic-related call or a different call that's outside of your jurisdiction, and nobody should necessarily be barking up your tree about refueling in another jurisdiction. As long as you know they want to ask you about it, just tell them like, yeah, just refueling, got done from a call out that I was helping you guys out with, or whatever the case is. Then. Just refueling, and I was going back to my jurisdiction. And that should be that. The other guys shouldn't be like
fucking Wade.
All sort of suspicious about it. You know, they should be like, okay, cool, get it.
Not FDP him.
That would be so funny.
Up and down outside of the jurisdiction, just hanging out.
Where does he go? Crashes his game.
That would be.
What the hell?
Is that Rihanna?
Yes. I think.
It's Disturbia.
It's a banger. It's a banger.
So we couldn't do no dancing in here.
No. Alright. So.
Oh, shit.
Does anybody have any questions about it going forward?
Yes. Oh, sure.
Sorry, I just stepped away for a moment. What did I miss?
About my Oh shit, no, sorry.
Sorry, who?
About the. Can I bring up professionalism standards? Real quick?
Yeah,
absolutely. Who's playing music right now?
It's I believe it's Miller.
You're not talking to
Wilson.
Just Wilson,
that is not
your mic. If you're not playing music, or if you're playing music, please. If you're not talking.
I promise you, that's Wilson.
Wilson, go ahead.
Which to talk.
Thank you, sir. So as seen yesterday, I did speak to, I believe it was Shane. It was either Shane or Trent about professionalism, specifically from. BCSO. However, I'm not going to pick out names because I'm not that person.
I'm aware of it too.
So I'm not going to pick out names, however, I think it could be improved, as it's not what...
Is that Wade?
I think people's capabilities are not being utilized directly.
No, I bet he's talking about Wade.
When it comes to standard size, and I think it may need to be improved.
I agree. Especially even...
I can't hear what you're saying, you're echoing so bad in my ears.
Nobody should necessarily be bitching around on the side of the road using explicit language like that. It's not professional.
Someone else is echoing really bad. I think it's Wade behind us, because I'm hearing it too.
You see his mouth moving.
So,
I got a question.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, we get 1080s out to the city quite a bit, and when I'm doing my rest reports, I tend to stop in the county, but I do advise one of their higher ups, and we'll sit window to window and talk while I'm doing my report, and then I'll head out to Toledo. Is that fine, or are we not doing that?
When you're down in the city?
Yeah, so like when I come back up, I got to go through the county to get back to Toledo, but I'll stop in the county and talk to their higher up for a little bit. But I do advise them that I am in the county doing a report, and we'll sit window to window and talk while I do that. Is that fine, or do we not do that?
I'm gonna turn you down.
It's Wade.
If it's just
let me see
chit chat while you're doing it, I wouldn't. If you were, like, for instance, booking a station in that jurisdiction, then let them know that's what you're doing.
Like, I've been
and then if you have a window to window with somebody like that, then that's okay. But for the most part, just do what you gotta do. The nearest station's fine. Just let that department know, like, hey, I'm in your jurisdiction, I'm just booking a suspect the nearest location, and then call out the postal and the station that you're going to. Because if you're in their jurisdiction, you should be on the radio channel.
Appreciate
it. I've got a question as well. You know, just make sure that you're communicating with your channel and then that department's channel.
Right. The main focus of this is right now is it's communication. You know, it's just because you go into another jurisdiction, it's not trench warfare. It's just make sure you're communicating the right things, right? Make sure you're, you know, your objective is, you know, basically everyone knows what you're doing there. Help mitigate any sort of issues or any confusion, right? The goal here is for all of us to work together and continue to in harmony, right? So let's just make sure we're communicating the correct things over radio and everything else when we're in other jurisdictions. This is it's pretty standard stuff. Yeah, go ahead, Jen.
So, say you're a trooper and you're say I'm calling this panic off, make sure you go to your supervisor or anything, because you know, a supervisor should be the one asking if you know that department needs additional. So make sure you know that you're reaching out to your supervisor, and your supervisor will reach out to that department and see what's going on. I think
I agree on that. Supervisors can definitely do that. Reach out and see if they have the units that they need, because obviously guys can tend to go AFK, step away, go to the bathroom, whatever it is that they're doing, so it might put you down on a couple guys. So the sergeants want to reach out and communicate with that, without them not being within the response range, then that's 100% fine. Just give me one second. But when it comes to you being within that range, what I've always done in the previous city is that I notify, especially if it's a panic. You know, if it's a panic, I don't feel like, you know, you should need to be requesting permission to go. If you're within that range, notify your department. Say, hey, panic's going off. This postal outside of my jurisdiction, I'm within range. I'm going to be responding. I'll be switching over to whatever channel that you need to switch over to assist with them, and you'll have ears on what's going on in the situation when you're heading to that panic. Now, if you hear multiple of, like, say you're a trooper, you get to go ahead of this panic, and you switch to their channel, you notify that you're switching over and that you're within range. They know that you're now at a channel, you're in their channel, and as you're responding, you can get updates to how many units are showing up on scene. If there's 3 to 4 guys that are showing up on that scene, then you're good to clear off. I know that when sometimes I hopped in channel, I've only noticed maybe 1 or 2 guys say that they're responding, because it was probably late top in the channel, because I have to notify my department first. So then if you think that there's still not enough and you happen to show up, there's, you know, more guys than what you thought was going to be there, ask them, hey, you guys need an extra hand? You guys got it. And then, you know, they'll be like, yep, we're good. Or, yeah, no, you're going to stick around and help us out real quick. This is what's going on.
Yep. Communication is key, guys.
I've got a question.
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, so this is all about jurisdiction during time that you're on patrol, right? Is there ever a time that we're not on patrol?
Sorry, can you elaborate on the not on patrol part?
Well, I heard you guys saying that, like, that's on patrol routes. Do do we ever get a time where like you're able to just go look at something and not be active? I mean, not Civ RP, but like not exactly on duty copper.
That's a good point.
I don't know what that means.
Solid question.
I've got an example. Like, there was somebody, I found a new building near the Sandy area, near the burger shot, right? And kind of like that. I go to burger shot sometimes, say I'm 10-5, which is like lunch.
Right.
Am I allowed to do that?
Yeah, absolutely.
And if there was an SASP member that was there, and I was like, hey, do you want to get lunch with me? Are they able to come to the burger shot with me? Even though that's not in their jurisdiction.
I don't necessarily mind that, because it's still within the role-play aspect. You know, you guys are, you know, in a sense, role-playing. You guys are getting lunch. That's fine, as long as you're not sitting there, you know, 30 minutes plus.
Right, but a state patrolman needs to call that out.
Mm-hmm.
They need
to
call into the radio to county and tell them that, you know, they're on lunch with a, you know, a deputy, whatever, in their jurisdiction.
Yeah, because there'd be times, too, in the other place that I'd be
it's a big thing here. It's basically, you know where people are and what they're doing. That's the big thing.
There's been times where I've called out too that I'm 10-5, and I'll
especially
go like, park at like a
jurisdiction.
I'll go park at like a gas station or whatever.
Accountability.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Yep.
Okay, cool. There's been times where
it's weird. If you move your camera wrong,
oh my God.
All you hear is the highway behind you.
I have my camera facing
it,
the guy.
It gets tough.
So
yeah.
Sharp, you keep interrupting him a little bit, so.
Yeah.
Sorry.
you keep interrupting a little bit, doggy.
mistake.
No, you're good. So there's been times in the other city too that I came from, and I'll call out like I'm 10-5, and I'll go park at like a gas station or, you know, even like a burger joint or whatever, and I'll literally get up and actually go grab food and come sit down and just kind of sit there and, you know, eat my food. And then there's been times where like a supervisor rolled up with me and they're like, hey, what you up to? I'm like, oh,
well,
you know,
this is retarded.
I'm eating right now behind my desk.
Let's go.
And be like, oh, okay, cool. You know, simple stuff like that. Absolutely. So if like two units want to do that, that's cool. As long as it doesn't become this party, you know, three's a party. So, or three's a crowd per se. So, if it's just two guys who want to do it, I don't mind it. As long as I don't see three plus guys sitting there doing the same thing. And that's absolutely fine.
Perfect. That's what I was just because I know somebody got talked to for going to the motel and checking that area out, how you can go inside and there's rooms and stuff. So just want to make sure that was all right.
Yeah, it's like
as long as they call it out.
Because Rockswood continuously has updates, and you know, we encourage people to go check that out. So if that's something you want to do too, just call it out over the radio, you know. You may get denied because, you might already be three units from your department doing that. So you might just have to wait a little bit for those guys to get done and check back in, go back 10-8, and you're able to go down there and do it. So check in with the supervisor, more or less.
Alright, sounds good. That's perfect.
Coolio. LOIs. You guys have a link to it in the directory. It's just a template. Give me 1 second. People are being fucking loud. Well, fuck it. I'm gonna say it anyways. So the LOI template is in the directory, and to basically do that and use that, you click on that, and it'll take you to the template. You go to file, you make a copy. That copy is now yours. Then when you fill it out accordingly. And I told my guys, apply yourself for the position as if you're applying for something you really truly care about IRL. If there's a certain position you want, you truly care about, that you want it, you're gonna apply yourself properly to it and not give a one-worded sentence. For me, literature is everything. If I see lowercase I's and no commas, no periods, and just poor literature skills, and you want to be a sergeant or something like that, that's a no-go for me, right off the rip. Personally, for my department at least. Obviously, the O1s are different, but you know, standards are set high for those certain positions, so make sure you're definitely applying yourself well to that. So once you have filled that out, after you've made a copy, click on share. And then make sure that anyone with link has viewership instead of it being restricted. And then you take that link that's in the search bar, copy the link, open your department support ticket, not a server support ticket, a department support ticket, submit it in there with your link. It'll say LOI on it. And then command sergeant, or I believe it's just command member, CPC ticket. See the ticket, you'll see the yellow eye. And then to avoid the ticket from being closed by somebody else, because staff obviously oversees the tickets too, to prevent it from being closed or deleted, command should then reach out and say ticket or LOI is in, comma, ticket pending, and that'll let them know. So, other than that, that's how the LOIs are gonna kind of work. Do reach out to your department supervisor, because they might restrict LOIs for being, you know, only for certain positions. I don't know how your department wants to run it. For myself, for example, as of right now, it's going to be available for deputies because we're trying to, you know, fill those slots, get the proper people in, and get the ball rolling. As time goes on, we get more guys. I might move.
Man,
it up
if they don't wrap this up,
aren't you a deputy now?
So, yeah, other than that,
I got to fill out an LOI for a deputy.
Reach out to your department supervisor and see how they want to work down that.
That's what he said.
Oh, you just got to finish your eval. I think maybe senior deputy. Mm-hmm.
This guy
yeah, we'll just use one for example. There's a couple of DCSO on. There's not a supervisor. How do you want to go about that, Alex? I know DCSO still has jurisdiction in the Toledo area, so if they need assistance, they just still go over radio.
So the way I want the way I want wire guys to work, that's a good point. I've yet to bring this up. Because we still technically have county jurisdiction within Toledo and Roxwood. Until that becomes, God forbid, another department, but maybe it will down the line.
So don't say that.
Just what we need, another department.
More work. Anyways, so if Charlie 302 and Charlie are going to be at 546 having a briefing.
Hold on one second. 107, could you mute your mic real quick? There's a lot of echo.
546. So the way I want the whole Roxwood and Toledo area patrol to go. I might start assigning sections to patrol districts within our jurisdiction. Hopefully with this, we're coming up with some new improvements for the server.
I know they were talking about waiting.
Kind of
he was like, yeah, I'm already aware.
But there's a lot
when he brought
more
up like a professionalism thing.
But as
said
right
it to
now,
who?
I'll probably come up with some sort of logging on
that,
patrol log.
I think it was Miller.
Talking about Wade.
He'll fill out this little form.
Yeah,
that,
he, Sheriff Allen was like, yeah,
select,
I'm already aware.
A patrol district, and it'll also have a tracker, so that way you can see who is all patrolling.
He's like, I'm
district.
Not gonna call out names or anything. He's
so
like, yeah, yeah, don't do that, but I'm already
spread
aware.
Of units in certain districts. But more of that to come. But as of right now, if you want to patrol up in Toledo and Roxwood, Toledo guys, notify the BCSO guy, and then hop into Channel 2 with Toledo Bay, because they're going to be the nearest department that can help you out and get the quickest response time. Whether you go down or there's a person with a gun, you can reach out to Toledo and they'll help you out. But obviously, you know, if 1080 breaks out and it starts going, you know, on the highways, out of Toledo, by state, and notify BCSO that there's...
Don't we all already know that? I'm new, and I know this.
State's notified, and then that way, we'll kind of be on edge to see if that pursuit comes within the county. We have a heads up, still, that there's a pursuit going on, whether it's Sonora or Great Ocean, you know, because there's a lot of turns that they could take that could put them on county roads, so...
Yeah.
With that being said too, pursuits, if you're the last unit, whether you're secondary, whoever is the furthest unit back in that pursuit, there should only be a total of 4 guys for pursuit, unless a supervisor wants to attach as a 5th, then that's fine, that's within the SOP. But if you're the furthest guy back, and you're going to another jurisdiction, it's your job to switch over and notify other departments that there's a pursuit heading towards their way. With that as well, I guess I'll bring it up too, because I did bring it up to the BCSO guys at Sunday's meeting. Priorities, there should only be one priority going on at a time. If there's a pursuit going on, officer goes down, then 22 the officer down, at least make sure that there's a guy over there getting the officer down back up on his feet, 22 that call, and wait until that, you know, pursuit gets done, and then you're able to, you know, do your officer down call or whatever they it'll help you guys from not wanting to pull your hair out of your head, so there's that.
So, I'm sorry, just a question. So the priority that's already started is the one that should continue rather than an officer down priority?
wouldn't the officer down take priority?
That's what I'm saying. Like, that's more like that doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
So essentially what that means, right, is like no matter what the priority is, if another one kicks off, the first one that kicks off should have priority over whichever priority that tends to kick off. It's like, oh, I mean, if you guys want to work it that way, that's fine. You know,
first come, first serve.
Yeah, well, what if there's a panic?
Well, that's up to Sharp. Sharp, how do you want to work that? I mean, I guess we could just cover this right now. Because normally, normally it would just be first comes, first serve. On
it is not that big of a deal, people.
And what we mean by disregard, just like pretend it didn't fucking happen. Like, but,
I mean, to come down in radius for us.
But if you guys, if you guys want to enhance
within
that
a mile,
RP,
within a mile of our jurisdiction.
Okay, so it's not just if there's an officer down, don't send anybody. It's like if there's an officer down, no, there wasn't.
Type deal, yeah, exactly. But obviously, with our medical script, you know, get them up on the feet. If that's something you guys want to veto and change, then feel free to open a department ticket, because we normally just set it up that way, to where it's first come, first serve. And then if people want to change, and you know, rather than causing this whole civil war about it, then we could change that, absolutely. Anything's up for debate, so we're always open to suggestions. We're not saying that you can't do that. But if you guys want to open that up to suggestions, and you guys want to veto that and change it up a little bit to where any priority that kicks off first, you focus on that one, unless it's an officer down, then you can, you know, you can scratch that 1080, get the plate, and then go assist that officer down.
At least the back of your shirt doesn't say cadet trainee.
That's true. I don't think I'm gonna put my hat on. I'm gonna see if anybody says something to me.
Anybody have any other questions?
Yeah.
I got a question real quick.
Of course you do.
About the jurisdiction. Mm-hmm. What if we, as a trooper, patrolling a highway that's in another jurisdiction?
As long as you're on the highway, that is your jurisdiction. 100%.
Copy.
Damn, newbie!
Okay. So am I hearing that... So can BCSO still use those highways?
So the only time they should be on the highway is when they're either going up to Polito or down to the city for a call. I do know we have other routes to the city, but Polito, the only way to get there is by taking either 68 or Joshua to 13 or Great Ocean to get up that way. They should not be doing any traffic stops on the highway. The only time you should ever find a BCSO guy on the highway on a traffic stop is if they're like near Joshua or near 68. The only time you should see them on the highway is if they were to, for example, like I pulled over some dude with like no helmet on a fucking four-wheeler that turned on the highway, and then pulled him over, and then I requested a state unit for jurisdiction purposes, you know, and let them know. So you could either hand it off to them, or I mean, since you are the initiating, you should necessarily be conducting the traffic stop. But if you want to call a state unit for jurisdictional purposes, so that way any other highway units pass by, they see there's a state unit there. But more or less, you should still reach out to the channel and let them know that, hey, pulled over a guy just off of Joshua.
Mason, your mouth is open all the time.
You're technically in jurisdiction working this traffic stop.
I got the face set.
Okay, I feel like there's a lot of places that 68 is a pretty huge thoroughfare for, like Bolingbroke, the airstrip, even the military base. So we can't drive on it. I feel like that cuts out a lot.
Yeah, you can drive on 68. Because like, if you look at the map diagram that's in there, you'll see the.
Look at my face right now.
68 is pink.
What's he doing?
So that is highway. But essentially, county guys can still go up and down.
What is
that? Don't do that one because it looks like I'm
pulling. Now, granted, there's a lot of guys who. What? What's up, Sharp?
Yeah, it's a shared jurisdiction.
Yeah, it's more or less shared.
Okay. But the highways are not.
Yeah, but the highways are absolutely, absolutely state.
So, just to clarify.
Even if
this,
we were going to, like, the quarry?
The quarry?
Need to call it out.
So Sonora Way is right off the quarry at the entrances.
Like, it's just weird.
So the quarry is definitely a county jurisdiction because Sonora Way kind of goes down, and then eventually it'll connect up to Palomino.
Or like the Power Strip and or News Headquarters.
Yeah, that would be county two. And a part of me has also been wanting to draw a pink line down Sonora Way too, and continue it to be like this shared jurisdiction. Like
mine cuffs on your screen?
Yep.
So
there's a lot of shared jurisdiction. Okay.
Yeah, only at least for right now, from what's actually written on paper is 68.
Right.
Why am I
interesting? Just sounds like a lot of patchwork.
Because obviously there's going to be a lot of highway for state guys to cover.
I can't even move.
Not everybody's going to be on at the same time, so still having that shared jurisdiction on 68 between state and county guys is still, you know, it works hand in hand. It still makes sure that it gets covered.
I feel like a lot of people are just getting upset for not. Like, there was somebody, a SASP member, that got yelled at for driving on 68, which is shared jurisdiction, so I don't know, maybe people just need to, you know, look at their jurisdiction, because they shouldn't be getting mad at people for SASP.
Yeah, I agree. So anything that's covered in the brown, covered in the brown and have a pink line through it is a shared jurisdiction.
So just to clarify, I think you said earlier that Blaine County is going to be patrolling up in Toledo as well?
Yes, sir.
Even though that's our jurisdiction up there, right? According to the jurisdiction map?
The pink.
The pink is highway. The BCSO still has access to our jurisdiction because it was there, you know, long before Toledo Bay even came into park, obviously. So, you know, like I was saying, if you guys need...
take that, fuckers.
Additional, you know, to help patrol there, then, you
know, you guys... Pussies!
I'll elaborate more on that too. The reason why is because one, Palito Bay does classify as a town, and there is more township in Roxwood, but at the same time, Roxwood classifies as a county. Now, we don't have a Roxwood County Department, because there still is a county area out there, and based off from what we're seeing from the Ambitioners Discord is that there's plenty more updates and chunks to be loaded in as updates come out. So it will be bigger than what it is, and it's going to continue to get bigger. There's supposed to be an airport out there. Whole bunch of stuff that's going to be coming. Even highway stuff is coming too. There's already a highway that is there, essentially. Granted, it's very short right now, but it's based off from the recent chunk updates that I've seen, is that the highway is getting expanded on. So plenty more jurisdictional updates.
So much for creating content.
And I can obviously do a little more touching up on the map to make it more clarified on what's what. So. Obviously, diving headfirst into any project, you're going to have to iron out kinks as they come, so that's something we'll probably have to dial in on.
So basically, if we have, let's say, 6-7 Toledo on, we're not going to get county up there, but if we got like one or two of us on, we might see them up there, correct?
I mean, county can still go up there if they want. It's still technically a county jurisdiction. Per se, I would like to see them more or less in Roxwood than I would Palito Bay, because Palito Bay is necessarily a town, and so is Roxwood in a sense. So that's more or less a shared jurisdiction within Roxwood. County guys shouldn't necessarily be patrolling in the original Palito Bay part.
Wow.
Someone's a little butthurt about that.
Hey. Join the wrong department, dumbass.
I don't know, I'm just letting people think, really. See if they come up with anything else that they want to ask.
You got anything else, Miller?
God, don't ask him.
Not that I can think of.
Blaine, you got any questions, Oliver? Any of my guys?
No, I think, some of the questions we'll ask after.
Sean, you got anything, buddy?
clear understanding of what's what.
Yes, sir.
They're pretty good. Ready to go 10-8?
Alright. Alrighty, boys. I appreciate you meeting up. Like I said, you guys have any questions, you know, reach out to the supervisor and, you know, they reach out to us. If you, you know, have a question about something you shouldn't be doing, then don't do it. Hold off. Wait until you get an answer.
One more thing. Oh. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, okay. Fine.
God, I hate that hat. I hate it. Promoting teamwork. Promoting teamwork. It says.
Good job, buddy. Good job.
Thank you.
Oh, wait. I can't drive on this road. How do I get out? I guess I never leave.
Wanted to talk to the sheriff there and ask him how long this cadet is supposed to last.
Run in there and ask him. I also want to ask him.
Ask him what?
About my... Right, he's over here.
Yeah, they're talking. About your what?
No, I'll ask someone else. No. I ain't bothering him with that.
Hey, Shark. Commander.
How are you?
Oh,
Commander's back. Don't worry.
Can we talk about it?
Hey, Sheriff, you got a second?
Yes, sir.
Hey, I was just curious. I've been, you know, on here, I think, 3 nights in a row tonight, I think, makes 3. I was just curious about the cadet, what I got to do next.
Okay, so... Let me see, did you do your MOT first yet, by chance?
Yes, Ollie did all that.
Okay, cool. So, ping Lieutenant Anderson, since he's the only one who can do evaluations right now, ping him in the general chat of BCSO, see when he can help you out getting your evaluation done, and then after that, you complete that, you'll be bumped up to deputy, and then that's where it kind of kicks off from. So reach out to him, and then he'll get back to you, and you guys can arrange a time that works for both of you guys. I know Anderson mainly gets on a little bit later in the night because he plays while he's at work, so he should be able to reach out to you and get a time arranged.
Plays while he's at work, that's nice.
Yeah, it's actually very nice.
He said he's at work. Yeah.
Alright, man, I'll reach out to him, I appreciate you.
Yes, sir, no worries, I appreciate you.
Thank you. Where'd you go? Jerry did the magic trick?
Yeah.
I'm gonna run all the way up there.
Got a leaky brake caliper again.
How do you stitch people?
Gotta be a medic. Dickhead. Be throw a few extra stitches in that boy's lips over there, I appreciate it.
Mm-hmm.
Let him die. Let him bleed out.
Oh shit. I've got my headset plugged up, but it's still saying that battery's low.
It says apply quick lot packing, field dressing, or elastic bandage. No. It didn't give me the option to stitch you.
Oh.
Oh. Really? Man, you better get away from me.
Fixed up your left leg.
Oh man, come on, you're good now. Domestic dispute at La Puerta apartment.
We'll let you take it.
Yeah, it looks like it's just gonna spin.
Yeah, that's what mine did.
Oh, did I do all that shit to myself? No. Why is my screen flashing white?
Bad.
Oh, that's awkward.
Charlie 309, Charlie 604 are gonna be running Union one.
Well, I'm gonna die.
I guess I'll cancel this.
All the things actually.
Hit Z and then disable call out.
Okay. All this stuff enable. On the ground. Yep. I'm gonna have a heart attack.
Waste of time that meeting was.
Yeah.
Explaining shit you get explained like on day one.
It literally just boiled down to, hey, jurisdiction. Stay in jurisdiction.
What was that?
What's that?
I mean, you didn't see it.
I was like behind us.
just want to go back to our pot.
Oh, up on 68. Mm-hmm. I need to turn my radio back on, I think. Yep. Vinewood Apartments. It's that domestic dispute.
Yeah, it just doesn't work.
Yeah. Lane suspect, Route 68. Oh, let's go.
That's where we were at, wasn't it?
Yeah, going up.
No, we were next to Gilbert.
Thought we was up there. Damn!
Right where the sun's glaring straight to our face.
I'll be right back.
Alright. You're getting late.
Union 1, gonna be signal 11, 409, Wayne Beano Road.
He was doing 70.
70?
Yeah.
Was it 40 here?
Yep.
54, 50, 50.
15 over. There you go.
64 on this.
This fucking truck with the trailer every time.
52, wasn't that bad.
Thank you.
me? Pappy?
Yep.
Okay. My interface. Hey, poop. 55. That's my number. 15 over 59.
Yeah, they come down that hill, they just speed it up. Yeah, they turn straight towards the highway every time.
So we can't make traffic stops on 68, I just realized that.
Is it considered highway?
Yeah. So we gotta catch them going the other way. 57. God, he's going off the road too. Oh God, it's doing that crap again.
I don't have much trouble out of it.
It's never done this before. This is just started doing this today.
Very small vehicle, Bueno Vino Road. You see that?
Mm-hmm. Jesus.
I'm assuming that means it's a vehicle that shouldn't be on the road.
I'm gonna call it out.
Want me to?
Yeah.
Charlie 200, show me 10-7, 10-42 for the blue.
Anyone en route to a 911 call up on Winvino Road for a vehicle, a small vehicle on the road that shouldn't be. Airport fucking luggage. It's a luggage carrier.
Oh, he about died.
He hit the gas. So is this a 1080 or is this like just not like pulling people over?
Yeah, he's playing.
Oh my God.
Mm-hmm. Union 1, we're gonna have a very slow 1080, about 20 miles per hour, 414 on a tug. Passing 414, heading down towards Route 68 off of Buenvino Road.
Am I coming through the radio for you?
Yeah.
coming up on 408, heading down to Route 68.
You want to hop on state radio?
Is it three?
I think it's three. Yeah, let them know we're hitting Route 68. We got a
little car pickup mixed-looking thing. 2-4 Papa King X-ray 577
on
time, occupied times one, no additional.
BCSO state.
Go for state.
Hey, this is Charlie 604. We have a current 1080 on Route 68 heading westbound towards the highway, Grayson Highway. Seems to be a small tug, luggage tug.
Ten four. You said on Route 68.
That's affirmative. Almost the Great Ocean Highway.
Before I can make my way over there, I'll be going down the
Great Ocean.
Just so you're aware.
Yeah, you're right.
Ten four. Going back to Channel 5.
Echo 200 will be in route.
We're going to be passing 419 on Great Ocean Highway. State has been advised.
203 in channel for the 1080.
10-4, we're going to be passing 419. Coming up to 420.
E1CO6, what's your location?
Is that Wade?
We're going to be passing Ford. Go ahead.
The
1080,
Charlie 307, I'm gonna
unit you up. Got you, we're passing 420 now, Great Ocean Highway. Speeds are about 25. It's gonna be on an airport luggage tug.
This thing is gonna knock us all over the place.
Echo 200 in route. I'm at 247, Route 68, making my way down.
Yeah, four, we just passed 423, coming up on 424, heading towards the city now.
Where is everybody at?
Then Eddie's going to be passing 427 now. He's turning left onto disregard. We're continuing on Great Ocean Highway, passing 427.
We got a big one here.
Yeah. High octane action.
1080 is going to be at 435.
Stop, dude. I can't hit him. We don't have somebody here.
No. I can't believe nobody's here yet. Wade keeps getting fucking kicked. I love it. Like, we're going to get passed by this RV.
We're 10-20.
We're going to be passing 437 now. Still heading southbound on Great Ocean Highway. Getting close to the city now. We're going to have to alert now.
Echo 203, I'm second in that pursuit, taking over callouts. Gonna be continuing South Great Ocean Highway, postal 438, speeds of 25 miles an hour.
Switch over to city and let them know.
Yeah. We're gonna go ahead and advise PD.
Good BCSO to LSPD. This is Union 1 with BCSO. We are in a 1080 almost into the city on Great Ocean Highway, just past postal 440. One BCSO and one state currently passing, rolling up on 441.
Can 41 terminate? We have an active priority call.
10-4 terminating.
Clear. 41 going in for.
I was told to terminate the call.
Come on, away.
10-4.
That's dumb.
That could have been great.
Union 1 going back to Nashville County.
That's terrible.
Charlie 311, 1011, South Pentagram Drive, 277. Blue and color four door vehicle, my time is 1, no additional technical.
That freaking sucks.
There was like 8 LSPDs on a while ago, and they terminated? That's crazy. That could have been hilarious. Shit. Union 1 is now 10-8 heading back to county on Great Ocean Highway.
Echo 203 returning to state channel.
Echo 200 returning to state channel. You need backup or no?
Negative, it got terminated.
10-4.
That's the only bad thing about doing a call that close to the highway. You can go up in Grape Seed. We'll get that shit squashed before it gets to the city. Damn!
I feel like that's the most fun I've ever had is when I'm in Grape Seed.
Yeah. Whoop! Excuse us, pardon us. Let's see here. Damn.
Yeah, you guys are just gonna have to go ahead and terminate. They better have just been busy with something. Like, I understand if that's what it is.
He said there was already an ongoing call. Well, dude, we're going back to my channel. I mean, I don't know.
I agree. If we're going back to our channel, it shouldn't matter. We're just announcing our presence.
Yeah. No, we're going swimming.
No, we're going to.
They need your truck out, man. We're going to bottom out this damn thing.
Skates.
Whoopsie daisy.
There's no way. That never happened.
We're gonna die.
Charlie 311, requested one taxi westbound Panorama Drive, 2774, what's the most?
What?
I don't know,
man. 311, also requested one County Tow, 277 East Panorama Drive for Boone Play
412. County Tow, sound like. Yeah, he's on the radio, I can't understand him at all. I don't know what it is. Mm. I'm glad nobody's around to see this shit.
Given.
Somebody didn't have their seatbelt on.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's gonna beat the shit out of you. Fucking up this country. You
sorry bastard. Oh, they're fighting each other. Fucking oh no, beggar.
They're
fighting.
Not.
Shoot!
Look. Man, why didn't we fight them?
Ah, Christ! Not that again.
Well, are you dying? Your mom will get on the other side of the road. He's gonna run you over.
Someday, please. And alive.
He's stomping. I gotta hurry up and do this. I can't.
It's usually pain. Yeah, it's just active pain. That's all you got.
Says I got a contusion.
Yeah, but that's. You can't do nothing for that. Oh, man. Look, your tire's gone.
What do you mean? My airbags out? They are.
Dead body found East Joshua Road. That's a detective call out.
Oh, we'll take it.
Oh.
Charlie 306. Be out in traffic. Be 1080 on West Joshua Road with a gray Jeep. Requesting additional units.
Well, you want to go help him, or?
Did he say
Paris Postal is 233 yeah. Heading south on Joshua Road.
Charlie 304 en route. Union 1 en route.
I'll keep that call out. Seatbelt. That postal?
I didn't catch it. I just heard East Joshua Road.
On Snorer Road South at 227.
He's close to us then.
Yep.
You see him?
Yep.
Yeah, he is. He's always fucking crashing.
Union 1 will be third in this pursuit. East on Sonora Road, 523.
Happening?
I have no clue what's happening.
Echo 51 to county.
Go, county.
Are you gonna be all good with that shot spotter down there?
Charlie 107, yeah.
It was from my scene. I don't know what happened. As soon as I pulled up, it just popped up out of nowhere. But there was no shots fired.
Health on Snow Road, Postal 540.
10-4, if you're all set with the shot spotter, I'll go ahead and go back to Channel 3.
What the
51,
hell?
51, show me 10-1 back to Channel 3.
Well, the Smith guy totally disappeared on my screen, and then the other dude just stopped and pulled over. That was in front of us.
I've never seen a car. I just seen them. I never seen a car. Call us out to that call there. Thank you. Call it out as a well done.
Anyone, we're going to be responding to a welfare check.
Mace, my head's
on Joshua Road.
Give me just a second, I can't hear you.
Union 1 on scene. Currently south on Mirror Park at Boulevard 573.
LSPD Lincoln is 305 on being route to that 1080.
I think I got it figured out. Where we at?
Coachella?
Oh, is this the dead body?
Yeah. I already called it out.
Okay.
I see a dead body.
Go look for it.
Currently south on El Rancho Boulevard, 794.
It's not in that RV, is it?
Ooh, I got him back here behind it.
Did you find it?
Mm-hmm.
Back here behind what?
Behind this trailer.
Ooh.
That looks like an older guy.
Postal is 790. On El Rancho Boulevard, heading west.
Yeah, so they're doing a... We can't even call it out because they're doing a... Victim is dead.
Already called it out.
I mean... Yeah. Well...
Call the corner.
Can't check his license or anything?
North on Carson Ave at 830.
Nicholas Hubble?
Yep.
Suspicious and nervous.
Yeah. He's dead.
Just see.
Charles 11, I want 1015. Northbound Jamestown Street, 831.
Hey, a corner and route. Let's see how that goes.
Coming in some good uncle too.
Oh, he's actually coming the right direction.
Dude, he is silent.
Carter Buck says he hits your car.
Over here.
You ain't coming all the way up here, dog. Get out of the road. There's a rock there. Oh, shit. Watch him go. You better watch out.
Switching back to channel 4.
He's gonna be bending in the back there. Look at him haul. Oh yeah,
don't fuck
straighter.
Around, man. No body bagging out, huh, fellas?
Charlie 311, Preston County, until eastbound Carson Avenue 29, Grand Theft Auto SUV.
Well, I guess I just end it through the Z menu.
Yeah.
And I was hoping that would end it like code 4.
Union 1 code 4, gonna be 10-8.
Bit of an off-road kind of strip to it.
Charlie 306, be back around county with 1015, Frank.
Union 1, we're going to be out with a couple subjects. Looks like a possible NBA here at 311 East Joshua Road, No. 32.
Let's just delete these and be on our way. Unless you want to run an NBA.
307 being at 1080 East Joshua Road, nearest postal 317.
It's hard to get the information you need from all this, you know?
We northbound, great pickup truck, occupied times one.
I'm gonna check the driver's if he's
hey man,
fucking
what you doing?
Been drinking or anything. He's good.
Me East Joshua Road, 089,
eastbound. Really?
Let's do a 304 en route.
North on Union Road, 095.
I got somewhere to be! Move!
Speeds are 50.
Kelly 01 to traffic 202.
I let him go because I didn't think we were doing. He wasn't. He didn't have it. I didn't know we were going there.
Oh, we don't have to if you don't want to.
I don't care. I just kind of already sent him. Pepper spray, bank card, yeah.
I don't think she's related.
I think she was in the car with the Mexican boy here.
Late west on Union Road, postal 108.
Man, your driver's license is expired.
Is it?
Jeff Slaughter? As hell, since 2019. Prison.
Out west on Grapeseed Main Street, 121.
That was a joke. He's not actually going to prison for it.
You get a motor vehicle accident after having a license expire for fucking 5 years? You at least go to jail and get bailed out.
Moron!
Well, fill out his arrest. I'll fill out the,
Probably 307. Can we get an additional 32 for this 1080?
Oh, you're the last one that had him. That's why it's doing this.
East on CV Road, 111.
Shithead!
Yeah, it's now it's gonna fucking trip out on me.
Vehicle 1050, CV Road, nearest postal 111. One in custody.
Whoa!
What you gonna get him for?
Huh?
What you gonna get him for?
I don't know. See what's in the report. See what my choices are.
Got me an NBA in. Crashing like hell.
Currently 307, can we get a county tow, CV Road, near postal 111, pickup truck, all fours up?
That's probably gonna be it for me tonight. I know it's early. That meeting about put me out.
Okay.
But I will be back on tomorrow. Zach should be on tomorrow too.
We'll see.
If he's not, I'm gonna be pissed off.
All your shit's still blocking the road.
I thought I deleted it. Alright, I love you.
Love you too.
Seven, I'll be 10:15. Mike and route to the same stores jail.
Charlie 304, show me 10-8.
I don't want to do it.
You motherfucker!
What the hell are you screaming at? Go ahead.
See you 10-4.
Hey, hurry the hell up!
Yeah, Union 1 is now 10:42. Going to 604 is 10-8.
Bullshit!
10-4.
Hey, get a move on!
Well, shit.
Dispatch, Charlie 307, I'll be 10-6 back forward.
Charlie 604, we run a signal 11 on Seaview Road 104. Charlie 604, active 1011, no additionals needed this time. Postal 096 on CV Road. You're not a Roberto. Dispatch, we're going to need county tow at CV Road 096. Charlie 604, show me 1015, one female, back to station.
Charlie 306, be 10-7, 10-42.
How's it going?
You as well.
Where are you going, buddy?
You also.
Charlie 604, show me 10-6 for paperwork.
Charlie 107, 10, 6, 4, paperwork.
dispatch, right 307, 10-8. Charlie 604 is going to be 10-7, 10-42.
How are you all?
Y'all be safe.